Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about osteochondrosis. Demnology, collection of poorly understood disorder of a major skeleton, more than 70 entities, many with able name. Many asymptomatic growth disturbance elements of idiopathic osteonecrosis and or overuse injury. Symptoms vary: asymptomatic pain, long-term growth disturbance. Outcome vary: resolution of cell-limiting process, permanent deformity if untreated. Presentation: site-dependent, pain limb or limb deformity possible. Imaging affects certain sites where bone growth occurs by endochondral ossification, epiphysis, more than metaphysis. Radiogram, fragmentation, sclerosis, flattening, depend on location, symptom, and patient age. Such findings do not necessarily indicate disease. Normal variants of vascular epiphyse, physical ossification can occur at certain location. Upper marrow and soft tissue edema typically correlate with symptoms. Subtracted pre post contrast T1 FS image may show decreased enhancement in setting of ischemic necrosis. DWIADC may also reflect ischemia. Lateral radiograph on the left and sagittal T2 FS image on the right of a 12-year-old boy with anterior knee pain. So fragmentation of the inferior pole of the patella with adjacent of soft tissue swelling. The findings are consistent with signing Larsen Johansson syndrome. Oblique radiograph on the T2 on the left and T2 FS image on the right of the left put in a 17-year-old girl with Freiberg disease, so flattening and sclerosis of the second metatarsal head. Additional, the MR saw adjacent marrow and soft tissue edema. AP radiograph so downsloping, peaking, and irregularity of the major tibial metaphysis. Coronal GRE so abnormal ossification of the major tibial epiphysis and metaphysis with an osseous grid crossing the physis. AP radiograph on the left of 8-year-old girl with Paner disease, so fragmentation and sclerosis of the capitulum. This associated low signal intensity at this level on the T1 and T2 FS MR image with intersphere increased signal intensity. AP radiograph of the bilateral lower extremity in a 4-year-old boy, so medial tibial metaphysis, downsloping, irregularity, and peaking, typical blunt disease. This bony deficiency of the proximal tibial epiphyseal ossification center medial. This is the GREMI I'm in the same patient, so the major tibia metaphyseal breaking with hypertrophy, inferiorly slow, major epiphyseal cartilage, subtalmaja bony bridge, connect the metaphysis and ossify epiphysis bilaterally. Treatment: conservative therapy with rest is effective for many. Certain entity, long RCP, often requires surgical intervention to preserve long-term function. Thank you.